He nodded up at Amber and vanished through a side door which clicked shut behind him. The stairs clanked metallically as Mal descended 9 steps in pitch dark, turned down another 9, following the rail with his hand, then another flight, and on down several further levels. He ran his fingers lightly through the dust on the rail. At the bottom, through a door, was an outside space among the struts beneath the building, which he'd made into his own. Hidden there, he could see the road leading from the city up the valley. Twisting tightly round the cliff to the club's front entrance, car lights swerved through the night as they climbed, swinging cautiously in lanes so as not to break the barrier and fall into wreckage on the rocks underneath. Across the city, swelter, shone the sun, where a dog-faced moon leered down like a floodlight. He was too far away to see the shiver of the waves, but would swear he saw its surface swell and sigh, as if a liquid muscle flexed below the shimmer of its curve. Wasps buzzed suddenly behind him. He turned, clambered in between the beams, further inside the hill, through a pale, weeping light where the long grass rustled. "I'm on my way," he said through his flesh, then froze, for there hung a figure in a pale blue straitjacket, fixed to a harness on a rope within a wooden frame. "Your craze was chickenpox, mine was alcohol," came a voice of sighing shingle through the outsized pug's face, measurelessly ugly and exhausted and sad. The rope, playing out from the flame, let the figure down 2 feet and stopped, so it bounced in midair before ascending again, as it had done throughout its life. Now a hum sang thick upon the air, as the figure choked a sob back and spat dry sand. "See the space of Siberian heart in your eyes. I think you know it shows through," came the voice, falling out from the rank grey muzzle to the ground. Malstai took a gun from his pocket, shot the face, shot it 7 times more, then another 7 times, till it wept black hamburger tears on its jacket. "Don't worry, you're too ill to die," spat Mal, as if to cut through glass. He wheeled round, threaded through the struts, found the door, climbed the stairway, returned to his box, and made the music leap